join us from another collection. She actually came here from Germany, from Hanover Zoo, in the last couple of years to have the opportunity to breed with Dot. You can tell Carl apart from the other girls because she's quite fluffy. I always think she's a very pretty gorilla, and she does know it. Now that is all our gorillas here at the zoo. Now you might be wondering why we have gorillas, why we also go to so much trouble to try and breed them successfully as well. And the reason is because gorillas are a critically endangered species. So what this means is there's a real risk we could lose wild gorilla populations, and current projections are that. And he does have those characteristic silver hairs that run down his back and onto his belly and his legs and his knees as well. And that's why adult males are called silverbacks. And they get these silver hairs in maturity. And the reason they are so much bigger than the girls,
of course, is the protect his family. But also manage his family as well, sort out any scores that might arise. And also, of course, the scrubs try and impress his ladies. Dobby is fully grown. He's actually an older boy now. Dobby turns 35 years of age this year. Gorillas are quite long-lived, it's kind of comparable to one
male, but
39, he's very much
finished
by our age. As you can see, he's 5 feet, very healthy, and he still weighs about 30 stone, that's 3-0, so Jock is still quite a serious unit to contend with. Still doing a great job looking after his family, and still rather popular with the ladies, if you catch my drift. So I will introduce you to a few of them. Correctly in front of me and Becky, just to the left of the screen is Kira. She's our oldest female and our largest female as well. Really cut in all the things. Kira's a little bit bigger than the other girls. She's just in her late teens. And our gorillas here, apart from Western Logan gorilla, endangered species, freely grown, and there's a mountain for you. So every single one of them is precious, and they are contributing to gorilla population in captivity. They are, of course, amazing ambassadors for their wild counterparts.
And their wild counterparts
are endangered because they do take an awful lot of threats, like so many